I just wanted to start it off the show by doing something on a rather somber and serious note. As you probably are aware, there was a fourth fatality on a road that has to be described as one of the most dangerous roads in New Jersey, if it hasn't already been, and I'm talking about Kozloski Road in Freehold. Just this past Saturday, I believe it was, 70-year-old Howell Boy was killed in a two-vehicle crash near Route 33 in Kozloski. This is the second deadly crash on that roadway in a little more than a month. Now, it turns out that the boy, let's see, his name is Jose Julio Tello. This happened again, as I said, on Saturday. Was the fourth person to die on the road since August 19th. Now, one of the victims of the August 19th accident was Noel DeLuccio. We have her dad on the line right now, and what her dad is trying to do is get some, I guess probably get some barriers put up along the road. Tony, how, by the way, how are you doing, and how's your wife and your granddaughter doing?
Hi, Ray. Well, we're holding up as best we can, and we're trying to go ahead and take our steps forward for the sake of making sure that we can go ahead and give Michaela a good life.
Mm-hmm. Now, I've been following you on Facebook, and I guess there was one status update that you had where you said something along the lines where you wished that you could turn off your brain. I would imagine that there's no way that you could possibly do that. But if it's any, I don't know if it would be any consolation, if you can get some sort of a concrete divider or maybe some just some effort made to get that road safer, have you gotten any feedback at all from any officials that, let's say may have something to do with getting that end accomplished?
Well, I will tell you that this is something that I just started after hearing about the death of this little boy.
Mm-hmm.
Unfortunately, it's too late for him. It's too late for my daughter and the other victims. But, this is a common sense issue.
Mm-hmm.
How many more lives have to be taken before we go ahead and actually take action? They've put signage up. Okay. Well, nothing personal, but signage isn't going to stop
it. Yeah, that's what I was going to ask you. That was my next question.
That's something that just needs to be, it's a common sense issue. It's kind of like having a fire. You have to put out the fire and then do the investigation. This is a fire, and there are ways to go ahead and minimize what's been taking place.
Mm-hmm.
We need to minimize that immediately and then go ahead and go forward from there, do the investigations, do whatever permanent fix you want, but separate the traffic, the opposing traffic, so that these head-on collisions on that road stop.
Yeah,
I hear so many people talking about different things like, texting or this or that. Well, nothing has been resolved yet. The investigations are still going on. Even
okay.
The one from my daughter, in August 19th, it's still not finalized.
Because that was a question I was going to ask. And, I realized that is certainly a very difficult one to ask. But now you say that, who is it that is conducting or has conducted the investigation? And have they, from what I'm gathering from you, they haven't found anything, any other contributing factors. Am I correct?
I don't want to speculate. What I will say is that I've reached out today to the Freehold Police Department, who I believe is working in conjunction with the prosecutor's office.
Mm-hmm.
And as of right now, there is nothing released. So we are still waiting. There are certain things that apparently are pending. So in order to not constantly second guess, I don't want to speculate on anything.
No, that's fairly obvious. I can understand that. Have you, though? I mean, now, besides having reached out to the Freehold Police Department, you have reached out to, I guess it was the, was it the deputy freeholder of Freehold Township? I'm not sure exactly what the individual's title is.
Well, I believe it was the deputy mayor. I went ahead
and
saw
something. Right.
Yeah, I saw something that was written up. And with all due respect, it looked like politically correct answers with no solid time frames. And This is a call to action that we all have to take, and this is something that requires some type of a time on it. I need to know, you know, I don't want to hear there's going to be a meeting in the future. That's relative. That could be 10 years down the line.
Yeah, it's true.
We need something that is solid. When is that next meeting? When can I be a part of that next meeting so that I can go ahead and express my concerns? My biggest issue here is, it's too late for myself. It's too late for my daughter. But you know what? If it helps save the lives and there's no more little boys or little girls that have to perish on that road, that's why I'm doing this. I don't want any other family to go through what I'm going through now.
Exactly. You know, as far as that's concerned, as far as, you know, the timeline is concerned, that you would like to be able to see something being done. And you know, first of all, you know, I should have even led off with this, you know, because in the interest of full disclosure, now, you used to work here as a weekend anchor. So obviously we felt very close. We still do feel very close to you now, you know, pretty much how I feel about you and about your family and whatnot. But you know the power of the radio station and obviously the power of social media. Have you gotten, well, what is the, what has been the response so far that you've gotten from any of the efforts that you have made to try and see to it that, you know, barriers are put up or, you know, some sort of, I guess maybe safeguard can be put up on that road?
Well, I've gone ahead and since I've started making these inquiries, I guess you can say most of it has been done through social media. Since I've started doing that, all of a sudden the signage that I was talking about earlier is popping up. They now have apparently four signs on that road, and I have to tell you, I haven't personally gone and visited. I can't drive.
No, I can understand that. Sure.
But again, it's kind of like putting a Band-Aid on a hemorrhage. You know, we need to go ahead and actually stop this because I know those barriers may not save everyone's life.
Yeah.
I get it. But it would have probably saved the lives of the other people involved in that accident on August 19th and potentially this little boy.
Right.
I believe the gentleman's name, Mr. Kohler. You know, this man was a father. He's my age. He's driving, you know, home. And if that line couldn't be breached, he'd be alive today.
You remember, though, because, you know, one of the reasons why I even point out that that is probably one of the most, if not the most dangerous road in New Jersey, is I go back to, I guess, maybe about 07, when there was an accident on that road that involved three students from Freehold Borough High School that were drag racing down that road, and I guess one of them spun out, and they hit a woman that was driving a van. So, you know, in that particular accident, you had four fatalities. And for whatever reason, it just seems as though that road seems to be marked as, you know, again, I say one of the most, if not the most dangerous road. It surprises me that officials haven't even realized, even then, and at that time, I think the road was brand new, that that had the potential to be, you know, just a very, very hazardous place to drive.
Well, I think a lot of it, Ray, also has to do with a lot of these officials try to prioritize, you know, where money's going and so forth.
There's no doubt.
I'm not going to speculate and say, you know, they didn't want to spend money, so they closed their eyes to it. However, what I am going to say is we can't close our eyes anymore if that, in fact, is the case. And I'm going to make sure that I'm going to be a pit bull because this is for my daughter.
Well, I know that you are.
The last thing I can do this, I'm going to be a pit bull. And plain and simple, it is our officials' job to make sure that first and foremost, the safety of their people that they represent, that is first and foremost. Everything else is secondary, but people have to be safe.
Okay.
Traveling the roads.
Who is it that specifically... Anybody who happens to be interested in this issue, and I can't imagine that there wouldn't be too many people. I'm sure that there would be a significant number. Who is it that they could reach out to try and get maybe some meeting going or at least some action toward getting your goal met?
Well, in my particular case, I'm actually going down to the township. I'm going to start there. As I said, this is a relatively new project that... apparently seems to be gaining some momentum.
Mm-hmm.
And gaining momentum is dangerous because there's a loud cry because it's people's safety. There are people that live close to there that see this,
mm-hmm.
and they're starting to cry out. Unfortunately, there are people now that are joining this unfortunate club that I'm now in, and that's something that's not going to stand. And by no means would I go ahead and call upon anyone else that's also dealing with this, because everyone's got different ways of grieving.
Mm-hmm.
But one of the things that I feel I need to do is to make sure that this doesn't happen to anyone else,
if
that's at all possible.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I will be taking my trips down to Freehold and talking to them and trying to get my voice heard.
Right.
I can't give you specific names yet or specific offices yet, but I will.
Okay, well, here's the deal. I mean, as soon as you do know and as soon as you have those names, please, by all means, let us know so that we could publicize them, not only on air, but, of course, you know, through our website at nj1015.com. Tony, thank you very, very much. I know, again, this is a very difficult time. Please, again, pass along our condolences to your wife, and we'll hopefully talk again soon. Okay, Tony?
All right, Ray, and thank you for being a friend.
That's quite all right, Tony. Thank you very much. That's Tony DeLuccio, is the dad of Noel DeLuccio, who unfortunately passed away in that accident on Kozloski Road in Freehold back on August 19th. About 11:19.